नो फैमिलियर विद. तो व्हाट डज दी कमेंट्री से अबाउट इट? तो दी कमेंट्री से संसर्ग संभवा प्रधानम कुष्ठम आसक्ति कुष्ठ प्रभृति ना संसर्ग परिहारम दर्शयन्नाह प्रसंग प्रसंगाद इत्यादि. तो प्रसंग प्रसंगा, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय प्रसंगा? प्रसंगा अभ्यासेन कृतः तत् पुनः पुनः कृतादित्यर्थः. सो इट वेरी क्लियरली मीन्स दैट देर हैज टू बी ए अभ्यास फॉर प्रसंगा. जस्ट बाय वन एक्सपोजर और यू नो वेरी वेरी जस्ट बाय वन एक्सपोजर यू विल नॉट बी इन दैट much risk to get exposed, but like this is what abhyasa means, you know, being in contact with this exposed area for a long time repeatedly, it means abhyasa. So idam visheshanam gatra samsarshat pashadibhi sarvehi saha pratyekam sambandhit. So repeated exposure increases the risk. As we now categorize this COVID-19 into low risk, the moderate risk, and the high risk categories, here also, depending upon the exposure, you get the risk rate also. So, sahashayya sahasanat iti ekashayya, it means which. You are just sharing a cot, you are sharing some jewelry, garland, such things. That means you are, you know, having a very close contact and repeated contact. And this is what is very important for a Sankramika Roga to spread. So, Aupasargika Rogaha, Shitalikadayaha. So, now it also says the diseases caused by the Sankramika Roga are Aupasargika in nature and they are Shitalikadayaha. So they are, you know, the eruptive diseases which has, you know, tendency to erupt, like the measles, the chicken pox, all these are also considered under the Sankramika Roga. Sankramanti Avishanti. So the roga gets manifested by the entry of something from outside to the person. So it enters the body from person to person. It is very clearly stated that it is not just by the contact. There is something which has to come from outside to the body to have this disease. So Vijayarakshita and Srikantadatta mentions Bhutopasargaja Vyadhi. So this is also a reference which mentions a different name, that is Bhutopasargaja Vyadhi, which can transmit from person to person. So there you get an innumerable number of references of all these, you know, Sankramika Rogas in our Shastras. So the Gaya Dasa, yes, let's see how it gets transmitted. Now you know that the disease has to come from somewhere outside. Now, how does it transmit? So it was Gayadasa who, in his commentary, mentions about the transmission in detail. So this is not very much, you know, dealt with in detail in other textbooks, but Gayadasa, in his commentary, mentions this. Tadevam katham. पापकृतां प्रसंगेन पापं संक्रमति तदुक्तं चरके नरो नरकपाति स्वातस्य संभाषणादपि इति. सो और रोग प्रभावाद इत्य अन्ये. सो इट सेज द स्प्रेड इट स्प्रेड्स फ्रॉम समवन हु हैज डन पापा और बाय बीइंग इन कांस्टेंट कांटेक्ट विद देम. So this may be to the modern world, this will not be acceptable. Like, until late, people were not having this understanding of how disease manifests. Now, by this word, you can get a very clear understanding as to why this Roga has come into existence. So it is basically because of Papa, and being in contact with the Papi will give you or can spread it to you. So, or otherwise, it is because of the Roga Prabhava. So it is also said that it is because of the Roga Prabhava that this disease manifests. So, Roga Sankranti Kushta Prabhriti Papi Jana Samsargena. It is very clearly told, see, that Papi Jana Samsargena this spreads. So I think Gayadasa and Vijay Rakshita Srikantadatta all have mentioned this, but Gayadasa was the first person to, go in detail about it. So let's see now the role of Krimi in the transmission. So now we have understood the Samsargaja Roga. Now, is there a reference or is there a possibility that even we can call Krimis in this context? So here I would like to bring to your attention the shloka from, Ashtanga Hridayam, which says, Sarve Sancharino Netra Tvak Vikara Visheshataha. So the Vagbhacharya mentions Sancharino Pravesha instead of Sankramika. So he uses the term, very new term, that is Sankramino Pravesha, is the term which is used while discussing about the Sanchari Roga. Mentioned this Sanchari Roga comes after the Krimi. Sorry, it is the vice versa. Sorry, I have mentioned it wrongly. The Krimi is discussed immediately after the Sanchari Roga, it is actually. I mentioned it wrongly. Then this indicates the transmission by the Krimis, which is through Avahana. So Avahana Adhuna Krama Praptan Krimin Adhikritya. So how does it happen? Adhuna Krimin Praptvan. So Avahana here means that the body which is vitiated by doshas attracts the Krimi, which becomes a favorable environment for it to survive. This is, a very eye-opening, I would say, a very, very, very important concept that Ayurveda has, and this is very, very relevant to this day. We actually think that the Krimis actually enter our body just by the exposure, but here it is said Avahana. Avahana means to invite. You actually invite someone. So how do you invite someone? When you go to or you when you tell someone, your friends or your relatives, you invite them, you prepare your house in that way so that, they get pleased to be there. The same way the body actually pleases the Krimi. So only when the environment is favorable for the Krimi, we actually do the Avahana by vitiating the dosha. When our body is vitiated, then the Krimis come. This is how the transmission happens. So this is a very important point, and this has to be understood. And this is why, according to the vitiated doshas from person to person, the severity of, the condition depends from person to person. That is why there is mild symptoms, there are moderate symptoms, there are high risk categories. All these are only because of Avahana. So if your body is not creating that environment for the Krimi to thrive, then probably even by exposure, yes, the creamy may attack you, but then it will not do much harm in your body. This is what even the modern, the exposure rate, if you look at, is very, very big. But then people who are dying in terms of percentage is maybe less. So this is because of this concept of avahana and the vitiation of doshas. This has to be very well kept in mind while we deal with such people and while we treat such people. So this is very important. So who gets affected by these sukshma jantus? So tasya prakritir uddishta doshaha sharira mansa. This is from Charaka Chikitsa Jara, wherein the description of who gets affected is given. So tasya prakritir uddishta doshaha sharira mansa dehinam nahi nirdosham jara samupasevate. Those people in whom the doshas are not affected, the jara does not afflict them. So this is a very sweeping statement that Charakacharya makes regarding the affliction of jara by these extrinsic factors. So samupasevate iti bhashya bhuta vishesha rupasya jvarasyavesham darshayati. So in this context, it is the bhutavesha which is being discussed. That is why I am telling that we need to have an avahana for the krimis or the bhutas for it to manifest a condition in our body. This is a very strong statement that Charakacharya makes, and the commentators very clearly, clarifies what it means exactly. It is told very clearly, it is the samupasevana. So samupasevana means you are actually making a very special environment. So let's see some further references about sukshma jantus. So in the context of Charaka Chikitsa 8, that is the Rajyakshma chapter, Yakshma hamkruto ashvibhyam manusham anusham lokamagatah laptva chaturvidam hetu samavishati manavan. So this is the context of Rajyakshma, and in the context of Rajyakshma, it says Yakshma enters, or Yakshma is the cause for the disease Rajyakshma, and it is humkruto, it is by the attack of Yakshma that manusham lokamagatah, that the body or the manusha gets afflicted. And how? Because the manusha, the manusha indulges in chaturvidha hetu. So I have marked Yakshma and hetu as highlighted them. It just simply shows that only by hetu sevana. These are all supportive point to which I was mentioning earlier, that you have to have a hetu sevana, you have to have avahana for all these attacks to happen in your body. So what is Yakshma? Yakshma is a murtiman, and Panchabhautika Sharira is that which has a murti and which Panchabhautika Sharira. So that is known as Yakshma, and it enters into a person who has indulged in the hetu. So the hetu is very important here. So this point points out to say that sukshma jantus enter the sharira on exposure to them and afflicts those who already have vitiated dosha in them. So all these points put together, it becomes very clear that there need to be, a kind of environment, a favorable environment to be present for these microbes to attack you. And this is what vulnerable population and all those things mean. So vulnerable population means the doshas are vitiated, and most of the vulnerable population, it is the chronic diseases like the diabetes or the hypertension is what is proposed now. So it actually meets at a single point. So how? Kim visishtena? Vayunopa nitena vayuna samipa mani tena tena ye shwasa kasadaya. So it the causative agents are brought near to the people by air vayuna, and people of the location gets affected by the dyspnea, the cough, and other such symptoms, shwasa kasadaya. So this also is very clear. See, it was such a clear understanding that we had years before. So this is why we cover our nose and mouth. So it is very clear that these are brought to you by air, and it enters and gets effect and affects the shwasa kasadis. So it manifests as shwasa kasadis. So this is very clear. And then further in the commentary and even in the main shloka, it is mentioned tatra nasa randhra anugatena vayuna. So the vayu enters the nasa randhra and kasa shwasa pratishaya gandha jnanam brahma shiroruja svak indriya gatena jara masurikadaya. Now if you look at the context of this pandemic, that is the COVID-19, you get all these symptoms. You can just, even now sitting here, you can just Google, you can just look into latest symptoms of COVID-19. You will not miss even a single point that is mentioned here. So the kasa is there, the shwasa is there, the pratishya is there, gandha jnana, this has become one of the very important features of COVID-19. Anosmia is what most of the people are reporting. I'm sorry. So I also got cough. Yes. So gandha jnana, we actually, I had a chance to interact with some of the COVID positive patients, like one of my friends also mentioned it indirectly, not directly, but then most of them were telling that they report anosmia as a complaint. Even after they become negative, they are complaining of anosmia and also saying they have puti granata. That means they have a very foul smell in their nose. So all these symptoms point out to be very specific. How beautifully Sushruta Acharya has mentioned about this, and very specifically the symptoms which are now prevalent. So how is the mode of transmission? The mode of transmission is by prasanga, as we looked at earlier, and prasanga gatha sanspasha. You have to look or take into consideration all this while we look into the mode of transmission and the mechanism of transmission. As I said, the avahana concept is very important. And what is the effect? The effect of this transmission is, you know, it could be different manifestations like skin diseases, masuradayaha, it is called masurikadayaha. So skin diseases is there, the shwasa kasa is there. So all of this point out that the presentation can be microbial, it could be fungal, it could be viral, all this can be possible. All manifestations are very well, you know, mentioned in our shastras. So you have to actually take into account all this while you treat. And this is why we actually look into. Now, if you go by antimicrobial, antifungal, antiviral treatment modalities, you will, yes, maybe initially get a success. I don't say you don't get success, or when you target such microorganisms, you become very specific, yes. But then, when the nature of these microorganisms change, you get exposed to that. You will have to bring one more, another type of vaccine or something to combat that. So it is better to make the environment, that is the sharira here, pure, to get protected from this. So it is like wearing like when you're walking, if you get getting thorns pricking you, a stone pricking you, it is good. You can take that thorn and walk, but later there are chances that another thorn pricks in your leg. So it is better to have a slipper and then walk. So similarly, it is you correct your body environment so that none of these agents attack you, or they don't cause much of a damage even if they attack you. So this is what is the concept, and that is why our approach to these microbial, fungal, and viral infections are very different. We basically look into the Agni, because the Agni plays the important role in maintaining the sharira, the environment of the sharira. So if the Agni is strong, the digestion is strong, the mala production is less, and the ojas is there. And when the ojas is there, you don't have to worry much. So now let's see another big concept, is that is Sankramika Roga equal to Janapadvidvamsa? Now my topic is Sankramika Roga, sorry, pandemic diseases. I would like to bring your attention, would like to bring to your attention that there is a slight difference between these two. So let's see what it is. Sankramika Roga is spread by a contagion from one person to another. But whereas Janapadvidvamsa may also be a Sankramika, but all Sankramika Roga need not be Janapadvidvamsa. It is not always Janapadvidvamsa. So what do you mean by Janapadvidvamsa? We have already looked at Sankramika Roga. We will now look at Janapadvidvamsa. Charakacharya says that he has classified the grama, nagara, and nigama, and janapada. So here we get the reference what Janapadvidvamsa actually means. So grama means the village, nagara means the city, nigama means the state, and janapada is a very large area where the effect of this particular disease is seen. So when something spreads over a very big continent or a state, only then it comes to the form of Janapadvidvamsa. So this is very mandatory and has to be understood. This is exactly the difference between, Sankramika and Janapadvidvamsa. And further to add, a Janapadvidvamsa could be Sankramika Roga, which involves Janapada. So Sankramika Roga can obviously become a Janapadvidvamsa. Yes, there are chances, but it need not be always. And what are the other things? I think there is a lot of disturbance. Can you mute? Yes. Okay, thank you. So there has to be a similar presentation throughout. Only then you can call it as Janapadvidvamsa. Then the next important thing is Samanya Adharma. It should have a nidana or a reason, which is Samanya, which should have common to common. to all. The reason for this affliction should be common. It should have a common originating point. So that is actually usually the affliction of Vayu, Jala, Kala and Desha. So when all these get affected, then there is a Samani Adharma Janya Nidana. That is why there are similar kind of presentation, and then it is called as Janbodhudvinsa. And above all, you should understand one more thing, that all Janpadodhvamsa Vyadhis are, Janpadodhvamsas are not Vyadhis. Even, you know, Charkacharya clearly mentions that the earthquakes, the floods, the war, everything are also Janpadodhvamsa, because it is from Samani Adharma Janya Nidana, it affects the Vayu, Jala, Kala, Desha. And it has a similar presentation. So these are the main three criteria which actually decide the if something, if there's a particular incident, is Janpadodhvamsa or not. So it need not be Vyadhis every time. So now when we look at the Vayu, Jala, Prithvi and Kala, many studies and very interesting study which says, you know, there is a very big relationship between the disturbed environment and the pandemic diseases. We will look into it later. And then some examples of this, that the environment is disturbed, the land is disturbed, is that, you know, you would have heard of recent locust attacks in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh and all. So this has been happening throughout, you know, in US, in Europe, everywhere this is happening. And this has now spread to even India. And Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh are facing its wrath. So these locust attack are, you know, a kind of, you know, some insects which attack a very large area of fields, and they destroy all these grains and everything. So this is also happening. So these are all lakshanas of how a pandemic, you know, progresses. Then you would have heard that, you know, 52 bats died in 1 hour in UP recently, just I think 1 week ago or so. I think there was this reporting. And there is also a study which says that when there is pollution, where there is pollution, the mortality rate is high. So it very well correlates the pollution rate, as according to the pollution rate, you have seen in India also, Delhi, Mumbai, they are all having very high rates, and it is because of the pollution. So there are many studies also, very scientific studies based on it, and which very clearly says when there is a pollution and the rate is high, then the mortality rate is also high. So it all points out to one thing. And wow, okay, this pandemic is happening. Who survives this? Almost all the people in Janapada gets afflicted with it in varied intensities. So nobody gets spared by this. You may be negative. Now in COVID-19, you may not have become positive, or you're not positive, but then it has affected you. This is what it means actually, in true sense. It has affected your economy. It has affected the way you live. You know, it has caused so much of stress to the world. So all this are affecting people. It need not be that, you know, it directly attacks you and causes you a problem. So no, it is this indirect effect. Then, so whom those people who become Atma Gupta, who lock up themselves from the exposure site, they are also actually, this Atma Gupta word is mentioned, are also saved, survived in this pandemic. So it is very clearly told in Shastras about the lockdown. So we are following our Shastra, is what I think. And that is what is wise. Even if the lockdown, everything is lifted, it is, becoming Atmagupta as long as you can is what is wise decision. And who does sthana parityaga? So people who do the sthana parityaga of that particular area where the intensity is high, who migrate to healthy places and environment, they are also, survivors of this. And who have niyata ayu. So the people who, even if you don't get exposed and everything, if you don't have ayu, you will not survive this, is what Shastra says. So you also need to have something in hand that is lifespan. Lifespan has to be there in hand in yourself, otherwise you will not survive. This is what Shastra says. So it affects all the people. To this, I also want to add on. I think recently a doctor from Japan proposed that by this is going to be a long haul of this pandemic corona in India. And he also says, he speculates that almost 50% of the population will get affected by corona, is what he says. So there are studies about that. It means that no one will be spared. But then there is also a good news, which he says that, after some time, people will not be even knowing that they are positive. It will just come and go. So that will also be there. We don't know how it will progress, but there are many, many speculations. And this is surely going to be a long haul. What is to be done? Simple, restore dharma. So you have to restore dharma, otherwise there is no, just by creating a free vaccine or doing some innovative thing. No, you have to bow down to the nature. You have to respect the land or the environment. So what kind of, what do you mean by adharma? So adharma kaya va manasa duscharitam. So all the ill activities done physically, verbally, and mentally are adharma. So you need to take care of this. This is high time that, the environment has spared us. So that is why it is now, coming back. All these things are coming back to us because we have done so much of exploitation to the nature. So what is the way out? Live in harmony with nature. So there is also, I would like to bring to your notice a publication which is known as a book, which says Connections Between Ecology and Infectious Disease, edited by Kristen J. Hurst, which clearly states that the preservation of natural existing biodiversity is very important. So if you don't preserve these natural existing biodiversities, then human modification of habitat leads to changes in the composition of species. You just recently saw the locust. This was not there before, but now it has increased so much suddenly. So this is because of the disturbance in the habitats. And these species are often associated with a major reduction in biodiversity, thereby increasing the transmission of several wildlife-borne or vector-borne diseases, which implies 100% to COVID-19. And this possibility of pandemic was warned well in advance in 2007 itself. There was a research paper which was published in 2007, which is named the Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus as an agent of emerging and re-emerging infection. So this was very well stated in that paper, and it had very well told that we are sitting on a time bomb, but we very graciously neglected it. So now we are paying the price for it. And everyone is supposed to take, let's see how we can. This is what is the situation, but how do we take control of it? So everyone is supposed to take care of their health by themselves, which is known as prajna. So the prajna, which is known as the health intelligence, you need to have some consciousness, some health intelligence within you, instilled in you, only by which you can overcome this. Just by taking some pill one time or say one vaccine, no, this is not going to help you in long run. So now even Harvard Medical School approves that the health intelligence is the key for this. So it is now coming to that point. So how can we stay healthy during pandemic? So if a pandemic is happening, not only for specific for COVID-19, I am talking about any pandemic. So Sushruta Acharya says, being in Hitasthana, having taken Shuddha Ahara and do Prayaschitta and Mangala Adhikriya. These are some of the points and which needs to be looked. Now, you know what is Hitasthana. I don't need to explain it. Shuddha Ahara. Shuddha Ahara means that which actually points out to immunity. And I would say, I will tell you why it points out to immunity, because it is well known now that we are all striving to come out with some magical combination to improve immunity. Yes, to an extent, yes, this will help, but then it will not be a magical formulation alone which will help. So you need to take care of ahara. Here ahara means all ahara, vihara and aushadha. And prayaschitta is something told. So for no much other diseases, prayaschitta will be told. But here very specifically it is told atonement. That is, make amendments to restore the harmony is very clearly stored. So this is the way out. People don't even now, people don't understand. People just go around abusing the nature. So this is not going to work in long run. We have to create environment which is favorable for everyone to survive, not only human beings but all the other species on earth. And then it says you have to do the Mangaladikriya. So Mangaladikriya means Mangala, Japa, Homa, Upahara, Anjali, Namaskaram, Anjali Namaskaram, Tapa, Upanay, Upaniyama, Dana, Deeksha, all these. So there are different kinds. You have to be very, as the environment is getting polluted and as the environment is, punishing you, you have to bow down to the environment and do all these kriya so as to, restore harmony. Evam sadhu bhavati. So immunity to combat pandemics, how do we combat it? With Ayurveda. To improve immunity, so as I mentioned, Hita Ahara, here Ahara, Vihara and Aushadha are to be considered together. This is the way out to improve immunity. So how should Ahara be? So Ahara should be such that it produces Shuddha Kapha. So only that which produces Shuddha Kapha, which does not produce much of Malarupi Kapha, and that which helps in the production of Shuddha Rasa. Shuddha Rasa Dhatu. Only that can, be a Shuddha Ahara, and which in turn does Sharira Pushti. So there are studies now which supports this. It says WBC, the quality of WBC is very much required for combating immunity. This is very well known, and we know how closely the WBC are related to the Rasa Dhatu, and it is the key to immunity. It supports the above point. So it is very clear you have to have a Shuddha Ahara, and Shuddha Ahara will only produce Shuddha Parinama, Ahara Parinama. And that is why you need to take very light food. If your Agni is not strong, you need to take avoid all these junk and as far as possible all the indigestion causing food, viruddhahara, all these are to be eliminated with our in our food. Then how should be the vihara? The vihara is also very important. Vihara, you have to take care of your dinacharya. You need to do most of the activities told in dinacharya as according to the ritu, because it is in this context of ritu that all these are explained in social samhita. So the ritu is very important, and ritucharya can be followed only when you have a proper vihara suiting to that particular vihara, particular environment. So sleeping, you also need to give proper rest. You cannot be just doing some day sleep, night outs, and all those things. But just by following some healthy food, this will not get rectified. You need to give proper rest for your body. And you may be knowing that sound sleep is also a very important component for immunity. So to support this, I would say there is, the melatonin, which is known as the dark hormone. So this dark hormone is now speculated as a treatment for COVID-19. This is because, this gets generated only at night when you sleep. So this is very important. And only when you do this charya properly, give your body proper rest in proper time, in the proper way, only then you can have immunity. And how should the aushadha be? Now, if you're planning for a golden or a very magical formulation, then what should it do? So there are three things that it should take care of in the body. It should do agnidipana, it should do anulomana, and it should do dhatuposhana. Only when it does agnidipana, anulomana, and dhatuposhana, it is called as rasayana. And if you look at any kind of rasayana which is told in our shastra, it will invariably have these qualities. It may be Agnidipana, it should be Agnidipana, it should be Anulomana, and it should be Dhatuposhana. Only then it becomes rasayana. And there can be a single herb which can become a rasayana, like the rikuduchi or shunti, or it can be compound formulations like Chyavanaprasha, which also can become a rasayana. There is a very interesting observation that we have. It's also a publication now recently coming up, which shows an association of Chyavanaprasha. The states which consume more of Chyavanaprasha, they are seen to have a better resistance to COVID-19. So there are certain states, which consume a lot of Chyavanaprasha as compared to other states, and they have a better immune response to this COVID-19. So there are, linking points which we need to connect together to bring up a proper immunity. Only one thing will not work. We have to bring all these points together to actually have a proper answer to the immunity. So with this, I acknowledge Dr. Abhijit Saraf, from whom actually I have taken many concepts. Who is associate professor from Sri Saptarshi College, Dr. L. Mahadevan. You don't need introduction for him, and Dr. Ram Manohar, who is our research director, and I also thank Swami Shankaramrita Anandapuri, who is the director and principal of Amrita School of Ayurveda, and also Dr. Sushma, who is my colleague, who has helped me, for discussing all these points.